So good morning, everyone. My name is Deepti. I will be the trainer for the O2C flow, the order to cash flow. I'll just start with introducing myself. I have over 15 years of work ex, most of which is in the supply chain domain and in the Oracle space itself. I'm an expert in the Oracle Cloud modules. I'm also certified in Oracle Order Management Cloud, Manufacturing Cloud, Inventory, and Procurement. So because this module is like really large and there are like so many things you can try on, today I'm going to keep the session more theoretical. So how I have spanned this out in these 5 days is, today we will go over the introduction. We will see the capabilities of order management. So you will be introduced to every feature, every, like I said, the capability that Order Management Cloud in the current release, that's as latest as 19D, has to offer. There are many of the new features like which have come in 19B, C, D, which I would not have tried hands-on myself. But however, we will introduce every topic so that you're at least aware of the capabilities. And so when you have your discussions, when you're on implementation projects, and when you discuss with the customer, at least you're aware that, yes, it's available in the Order Management Cloud. And the limitations in all each, you know, so every feature, because this is continuously evolving. Many features have some set of limitations, which we will explore in this journey. But today's session will be more on, you can say, theory. We'll go over the introduction, we'll go over the features and the capabilities of order management. And from tomorrow onwards, I'm going to drill deeper into the order management, which you will need from an implementation point of view. Today's will be all introduction to all features and knowing what all can be offered. So this is my agenda for today. Okay. So this is the objective for today's course, that you will understand all the features. You will be able to explain or even understand how the order management fits in the entire supply chain offering. And then what are the setups and how do you do the setups? Where do you do the setups? And what are the features that the product offers at the moment? So here, our very first question about what is order management? Order management, it helps you capture a customer's demand. So every customer, they have different demands where they place need for different items to fulfill their business, right? So this is, order management will capture the demand, and then it will look at ways how to fulfill that customer demand in the most optimized way. So that is the core function of order management, that is to capture and to fulfill. So by optimized way, I mean that it should be optimized so as not to cause disruptions in the other supply chain business. So it also means that you could prioritize certain stocks from being consumed, like if you're doing an inventory management, or you could have certain priority customers or certain priority orders that you want to, you know, fulfill on priority over the others. So that is all what order management allows you to do. Okay, so here when we say capture the demand can come from various sources. There could be like, you know, like you're entering orders, say, through a mobile app, or there's a call center where people are calling up and, you know, placing orders that this is the demand. Please, and there'll be a representative who's entering the orders in the order management system. Then there are also like retail outlets, or there are different various partners. So all this comprises of capturing a demand. And by fulfilling, we mean where you fulfill the order and like where you look at ways how to fulfill that demand. So it could be that for a certain demand, you think it's best that you source it from your, say, inventory in X location, because that's what is closest to the customer, and, you know, your shipping lead time and shipping costs are going to be the most suited. Or it could be that the demand has come for such a product which you typically don't maintain in-house, but you buy it from a supplier. So it could be that for a particular demand or a sales order, you're looking at different suppliers to fulfill that demand. Or even in a manufacturing industry, it could be that you know, for certain demands, they are made to order. So as you get the order, you start building the product, and then you integrate to the manufacturing applications to fulfill that demand. So this is what I mean. And these literally can, the demand can come from various sources. At the same time, the demand can be fulfilled from various sources. So order management is sitting right in the center of all of this, and it helps you move the demand from external applications or internal within the cloud applications to external fulfillment systems or in cloud fulfillment systems. Okay, so it could be that your customer has not licensed Oracle inventory module or has not licensed the manufacturing module because they are using some other legacy application which they like to continue. So it could be that, you know, you're using just the order management in the cloud. So capability wise, yes, Oracle Order Management Cloud is capable to integrate to third party applications. So this is what I just explained, that you could enter orders into the order management cloud either through SBDI, call center. You also have, so the most popular ways are Oracle is providing the import templates, the SBDI templates, which you can use to import orders into the order management cloud. They are predefined templates. They have those columns all defined. You key in the right values and you load them into the interface table and run jobs to process them. We're going to see this mostly in our tomorrow's session. And you also have, again, the most next popular ways are to create integrations are using the web services. You have the REST services, and you have many functions in these services where you can just get the status of an order, or you can just, you know, inquire about the order as to in what life cycle phase that is, like whether it's the order is shipped or whether it's just scheduled or whether it's, you know, waiting to be shipped. So these two are like very popular if you're doing only a cloud implementation. Otherwise, it's also very common where, so typically it's common where your fulfillment system is in the Oracle EBS. So though I have put, like, you know, a box showing Oracle EBS, because this is also possible. So we've seen scenarios where the customers were capturing the order in EBS because they had their manufacturing and all other integrations in EBS, but they were getting onto the cloud only, you know, to use its scheduling, or you can say the routing capabilities. Okay. So here, once the orders are created, it goes through a phase called transformation. So once you get, you know, receive the orders, you typically receive them in the source systems format, right? So we have to do like a transform the order into, say, Oracle Cloud language. So you transform the orders in Oracle Cloud. You can enrich your orders. There are various ways, say, transform rules, transformation rules and all, which you can create to enrich the orders or to add certain details to orders, which you will probably not be getting from your source application. Once all that is done, your order is created. It is in processing. It decides which is the best way to fulfill the order. And based on that, it fulfills the order through these various ways. So you could decide that, okay, for this particular order, the best way to fulfill is it from the stores. That's when your order is fulfilled. Or for sometimes, you know, you, like I said, you manufacture the order or you send it to a supplier. So these are the back-to-back flows where you typically go to a manufacturing or a supplier to fulfill it. And even the dropship flows are there. We will introduce all these flows in our coming sessions. So here, I've listed like a lot of the integrated cloud applications, right? These are all, you know, different modules within the Oracle Cloud. And also, if you're maintaining, you know, if your customer has license to these modules also within the Oracle Cloud, your implementation is, like, you can say standard. It's like a standard implementation, standard out of the box with using the integrations that Oracle has built for you. And also, you get a lot of support on this, right? So when you have some issues because of which you're not able to integrate or your orders are not succeeding, you can really file SRs and Oracle is there to help you. At the same time, you also have external implementations. Like I said, it's very common for a lot of customers to not upheal their entire existing setup if they have, too many third parties involved. They typically like to retain, if there are a lot of customizations or integrations, they like to retain their existing application. But if they don't have much of that, they are fine to move entirely to the cloud. And these external integrations that Oracle offers, the web services, they do a batch integration and also real time. So there are many services which do real time integrations, and there are many which you can, schedule at certain time, which will help you do like batch integrations where you have a bulk of orders going this way or that way. And using these integrations, you can also receive status from your fulfillment system as to where your order is. If I sent a request to say manufacture a good, and after a week, I'm just interested to know the status of it. You have web services which will just get you the status of the order, and so that you can, keep updating to the Oracle order management. And then that's when your customer has a real-time view of what's really happening in the other application. So typically, these are the modules that Oracle order management interacts with, typically like CPQ Cloud, if you have the marketing and from a quote you're creating the order, financials, because you need to invoice all your orders, and costing, yes, you need to cost every goods that you're selling, and Product Hub mainly for the item informations, manufacturing inventory all for your components that you're storing. Now we'll get into seeing some features in which order management has to offer. So if you guys are familiar with ERP, any other ERP application or the cloud, most modules will have this the module parameter stage where you set certain parameters. So similarly, in the order management parameters, these are parameters that you set, say, for convenience, or you say like to have the right validation. Like if you see, the first point is to identify which should be your item validation org. So when you enter an order in order management, and if you key in the line item, you add an item, it needs to know that where should it validate the attributes of the item. Like what if the item is not orderable? It may not be orderable in one of the orgs, and maybe orderable in one of them, right? So which should be the item validation org that order management should use? You have the option to come and set that up here. So this is set up for each BU. It's BU wise. So every BU will have one master organization where you define your items and where the validation of every item is done against. You can come to order management parameters, and you have to set that value, that which is your master org. And the other parameters could be like credit checks. So do you want to perform credit check at the time of order submission? So that also you can set that, whether you can enable or disable that. So if you choose to enable at the time of order submission, it then asks you to set up another parameter that what if the credit check fails, what do you want the order status to be? Whether you want it to be created in draft, like whether you want the order status to be created and put on a hold, or whether you want to not create the order and just leave it in draft. So that, outside the system, you set up your credit, the credit history, and then you come back and submit the order. So again, every business has different needs. Certain businesses want you to leave them in draft. Certain businesses want you to submit the order so that it's at least, into the system. Like draft order is also typically in the system, but it's not, like a submitted one. Then you have certain parameters which revolve around the configurator module. So the configurator module is where you configure your ATO model, where you have options to choose from. So a classic example of for a configurator case is your desktops and laptops, where you can choose what memory you want, what screen size you want, or what additional accessories, say, you want to include, what RAM, ROM, processing speed, what different kind of processors you want. So that's the configurator module, where you configure a model and its options. So there are some parameters around that, whether you should create the order, whether the configurator should, be doing this or that, and what if the configurator has an error. Then, I repeated the first point here. Then also, when you do dropship flows, So when you create dropship flow, that is, you create purchase requisitions and purchase orders to fulfill your sales order demand, purchasing always needs a preparer to be associated. And what Oracle has tried to do in the cloud is, it's tried to do a, what do you say, touchless flows. So most of these dropship, back-to-back flows, all these, most of these flows are very touchless and they are very well integrated. So as you create a sales order, if you know, if you do your setups right, you could go all the way to creating a purchase order, which is a dropship, with the click of just one button, you know, when you're submitting the order. So when you create requisitions, you need a preparer. So in the order management parameters, if you set your preparer, these all, this flow becomes so seamless. And that's why you come here and set the parameter. But otherwise, if you don't set this, what happens is your requisition is, or your purchase order is in an incomplete state because it did not find a preparer to it. Okay. And then there are many other parameters. We'll go over the screen. We'll see this. So, in this, I've just put a screenshot so that, you know, you get a view of how the screen looks like. But yeah, let's log into the application now so that we see these, we see each of these features and these pages. So this is your landing homepage for the cloud, and because you're already undergoing training, I'm sure you know that for most of the setups, we get into a module called Setup and Maintenance. So you will have this like an icon here, Setup and Maintenance, or I'll show you the various ways that you can get into Setup and Maintenance. This is your username, okay? This is your username and the login. If you just click on this downward arrow also, you have a link here. It takes you to the exactly same page. Or also you have this, the navigator. If you go to navigator also, you should have Setup and Maintenance here. Anywhere you click on it, you'll be reaching exactly the same place. Okay. So in Setup and Maintenance, everything is grouped into different modules. So for today, our interest is to go to the order management module. And also when you select any of the functional areas, here it gives you all the required setups probably that you need to do. You can just change this to all tasks and go over each of the setup tasks that each particular module has to offer. Okay. You also have this option of typing in here. If you're unable to find, like here I'm finding the order management parameter, but sometimes, you know, you're not sure which functional area should I get into, where should I get, just come and type here. So, and your percentage is like your wildcard search. So suppose if I'm not too sure, I just give this order management. So because they say I'm not sure of the spelling or something, you can just hit on search. So it'll highlight that your respective page for you. So just click on this. So here, these are the various parameters that you can set up. So like I said, this is related to Configurator, that if there's some failure, that should you allow changes, should you allow the Configurator to make changes or not. And most of this is very self-explanatory, you know, the description that they've given. But let's see a few which we need for our order management. So this is all, most of this is all related to Configurator. So this is an important one where you have to set that for each BU, like I said, so which is the item validation org that order management should use to validate the items that are entered in your sales order lines. So here we are giving that for business unit A to F BU, we are using this as the master org for all your validation. For this particular business unit, we are using this inventory organization, you know, to validate your item details. This is the preparer field, which is needed only when you integrate to procurement. And you integrate to procurement typically only for dropship and back-to-back flows, okay? This is whether you want to activate credit check at the time of submission. So you also have an option to use credit check during the order processing cycle. So, you know, a lot of customers sometimes have a need that before you ship the goods, you want to do a credit check, or before you're actually integrating to invoicing, before that you want to do a credit check. And sometimes customers also have a demand that at both times you want credit check, at the time you're creating the sales order and at the time when you're ready to integrate to AR. So this, the parameter here in order management parameters, is only helping you to enable it at the time of order submission. During the fulfillment cycle, that is when your order is submitted, you do this through having this credit check as a step in your orchestration process. We'll see all that in our coming sessions, where you can decide the life cycle of an order, like how many, whether you want credit checks, whether you want some compliance checks. So there's also a concept called covered and coverage items in order management. That's like, say an insurance. Say you're selling a laptop and you're also selling, say, warranty, or you're selling an add-on, say a service warranty, or you're selling a subscription along with it. Okay. So that is a covered coverage item or a covered item. We have that also in one of our slides today. We'll speak more on this. So they'll just tell you that from when are you starting the service date for your warranty. And here, credit check failure. So like I was saying, if you activate the credit check on submission here, like what should be the status? We'll see this in our slide. The compliance check. If you're doing an order import, how many orders do you want to be processed at once? Okay. Then do you want to sell discount details for each BU, whether you want to sell it, send it to the billing system, or whether you just want to, you know, send the final price. You don't need to show the details of the discount. Okay. Then whether you want to enable approval process. So you just go over, you go over all these parameters. These are all parameters which help you in the order management implementation. And so a lot that this list is also continuously expanding. Like a lot of these features have been introduced very recently, say in 19B and C. And here I see a tab for pricing. We'll do this when we have our pricing session.